of their last two games. So with a win here tonight, they'll pick up a little steam heading into the playoffs, which might fare well for them in the postseason.
Probably not a lead they can rest on right now.
Not a safe lead by any means. If it is, we're going to be watching some.
rim and rebounded by the mark, rebounded by Chamberlain as Stephanie Charles
a 13-3 for our Concordia Stingers. Only 38 seconds remain.
And there it is.
As the Bishop Gaiters.
Gonna have to hurry. 3, 2, 1. She can't hear me, so she's not gonna get up in time. I wish I could project my voice a little more. So that will do it for our first quarter. 13-5 in favor of our home Stingers. And what'd you see in that first quarter that you liked?
Absolutely everything. Took a command and grasp of the first quarter for our Concordia Stingers. I believe she had 10 in that first quarter, as well as a few rebounds. A bigger number over there, but I have liked her play.
She's been doing a lot more than putting up points, because I'd have to agree with you. As there's still 50 seconds to go in the second quarter, as the Bishop Gaiters went 1-for-11 on field goals. So the teams are going to make their
Well, the stat sheet is hot off the press here. Six rebounds in this ball game. She's doing pretty good at the defensive end with five, actually. So Kayla Barrett playing. Play bigger in the offensive zone as well as this game ages. We got a score of 13-5. Second quarter.
As you mentioned, Gregoire Boudreau, great first quarter, as well as Caleb Barrett. Offense rolling in. We've seen it in previous webcasts, so we know they have it. As that shot is... But unable to get it to fall, so she will go to the line, though, for two shots. That's Anique Stephanie Charles.
Sounded as if you were preparing for a much more French last name than Charles there. To no avail.
Agreed. And she can't get the second one to go in. Gregoire Boudreau with a nice rebound. Over is, you see Alex Boudreau check into this game for Concordia. Boudreau now has it. As they're going to call three in the key, so that'll be. Joined us for our first game of this doubleheader. If you didn't, then I don't know what you were thinking, because it was a fantastic game. But we saw the Stingers jump out to a big. Throughout the second quarter, gave up the lead, actually ended up down by about 4 points after having a as the Bishops have shown that they can come back.
Yeah, they certainly have.
As now Profet comes in, a nice little inbound pass. Double digits once more. There's now Chamberlain to Stephanie Charles. And she swats that away with authority. Then get that out of here.
Not today, madam.
Not today. As Jean-Philippe gets it to Profet. And again, we're having some difficulties with our video on our computer. As we mentioned, hopefully things are going well, as Katie Germain Gregoire Boudreau is fouled. Stingers ball, as they got points off the last inbound from the exact same situation. Maybe they'll try the same play. Jean-Philippe for the long three. Ooh. Just off the mark. Profet owning. Can't get it to go, but she does draw the foul. Can't get the first one to fall, keeping this a 10-point lead. So both offenses having a little bit of trouble so far in this basketball game. Who's going to get called for the hand of the face? Going to be Boulanger-Paquette throwing it in.
Might have to buy a round of Red Bulls for the build. Second quarter of action.
2.5 minutes through. As Boudreau gets it to Jean-Philippe. money big. In the bank.
Money in the bank is right, Brian.
He's trying to find answers for his team right now. Why the offense has not been clicking so far.
At either end of the court, luckily, so you know the Stingers aren't having a very great outing right now, but the Bishop Gaiters are playing that much worse. So scoreboard sits at 18-5 in favor of our Concordia Stingers. Yasmin Jean-Philippe is 2-for-2 from three-point territory, so keep an eye on her as this game develops.
So 17:25 to go here in the second quarter. Anytime you say you got a 13-point lead in the second quarter and you say they're not playing that great, you wonder what the heck's going on, but, you know, they're not getting their best performance, as you mentioned, resting some starters, letting them recoup from some minor injuries. So you do have a depleted starting lineup. And right now, 13-point lead, they can't complain too much.
Some of their bigger players are out there still, though, so probably a little bit of an area of concern for the Concordia Stingers moving into the playoffs. Nonetheless, you're right, they do have a 13-point lead in the second quarter. However, their shooting percentages are a little lower. That's a big 2 points for the Bishop Gaiters as they get on the board for the first time in this second quarter.
As Roulette God Charles drains that one, making it an 11-point lead. That's an ugly turnover by the Stingers, but no one can grab the ball, and finally it just squirts out to Blanche Paquette. They get it to Stephanie Charles. Left-handed, but that's off a Stinger and out, so it will remain Gator ball with 11 seconds on the shot clock.
Remaining in the second quarter.
As they try to drive the line, and they're going to call a foul on Alex Boudreau, the 5'7 guard for the Stingers. That's the third team foul. There's a little bit of confusion in the booth as something was rattling around, and we're going to get a shooting foul against Concordia, so the Gators will go to the line. As that first shot is off the mark, Let God Charles trying to get the second one to go. And does so. So 10-point lead, 18-8, and that's airmailed. So another unforced turnover by the Stingers will allow the Gators another chance to bite away at this lead. As Trafford dishes it off to Blanche Paquette, a couple of spin moves and a bad bounce. Which is
seemed to have the release pretty nice there, just an unfortunate bounce for the Bishop Gator.
Seemed to be the story so far for the Gators. As they work the court, and Blanche Paquette puts in the floater, can't get it to fall. Unlucky, now the big three-pointer by Katie Germain.
And this is where the concern sets in for the Concordia Stingers. Bishop's Gators game is elevating, and they've only got a 7-point lead now.
And the wide open Gregoire Boudreau can't get the three to fall. Ooh, and Kayla Barrett goes hard to the court.
Bishops is on a 6-0 run right now, Brian.
So Stephanie Charles gets a foul as they go into the bonus. They thought it was a shooting foul, but the ref disagreed, and Gregoire Boudreau kicks it out to Boudreau.
Oh, big board there for the Concordia Stingers and Marie Profet, who's just been a beast in the paint here tonight.
She shows it again, dropping two more points. 20-11 as the offense starts to spark on both ends of the court as Kayla Barrett comes flying in to grab that missed shot. Jean-Philippe gets it into Profet. Now Boudreau gets it down to Jean-Philippe, and that bounces out. Unfortunate bounce. Nice play by Kayla Barrett. She continues to show why she's a super horse. Philly, sorry. And that long three-pointer is good by Jean-Philippe. 23-11 now.
Jean-Philippe now 3-for-3 from three-point territory. It's raining threes at the Beehive.
And that shot comes up short by Cote Coet. Stingers are trying to counter. Profet keeps it in, tries to go baseline, and they're going to call that foul on Bailey Trafford. Made a little body check on the along the line.
Not permitted, of course, in basketball.
We'll get our statistician on that. And there's, I don't think so, though.
No, yeah, they have confirmed there is no body checking permitted in basketball.
Wikipedia is good for anything.
Of course, not a great source if you're looking to write a high-caliber paper. The score is 23-11 with 3:56 to go here in the second quarter at the Beehive. Our Stingers out in front. We mentioned not a whole lot of moving around that these teams can do in the division. So
I have to wonder if that's really like the reason for this lackluster performance so far on both ends. Is someone's got to remind them that the Shriner Classic is on the line, and Stingers got to get their way back into this series. Already down 2-0, and it's only the, as they go for the third annual one.
Well, the Concordia Stingers, of course, playing to try and obtain their first Shriners Classic Cup.
It's more of a trophy.
Their first Shriners Classic trophy here at the Beehive. You mentioned earlier, the Bishop's Gaiters have taken the first two.
There's now Barrett. That pass into Pont-Denis is off the mark. They have it once more. The Gaiters trying to get some offense going. They have it on the outside. The Stingers doing a good job keeping outside with only 1 second to go. That will do it on the shot clock. So a shot clock violation against Bishops will give the ball to Concordia.
Concordia Stingers have 4 turnovers this quarter, so just something to look at stats-wise here. And Bishops has 2 shot clock violations.
It's a testament to the Stingers' airtight defense. Has a nice little fake by Jean-Philippe. And
that is the first 3-point opportunity.
Actually, a long 2-pointer.
Oh, really? She was on the line. Okay, my apologies. Still perfect from beyond the arc.
As now that 3-pointer bounces out. Gators back to having trouble buying a basket. The inflation rate's up a little bit. As The Stingers now working around Bouliou. That goes off her foot. She keeps control. She's just going to hold on for a jump ball, which is in Bishop's possession. As right now, both coaches seem to be a little baffled at the play of their teams. So we'll see a timeout to the Stingers. 2:28 to go. Second quarter. Concordia Stingers lead the Gaiters 23-11.
I was just talking with statistician Max, wondering why they call it a jump ball when nobody jumps for the ball as they do in the NBA. They just forward possession to somebody.
Did you come to any conclusions?
Negative.
Maybe a viewer at home might know the answer. They can let us know.
Our email is floating across the top of the screen. Let us know.
You'd like to help us out with that one? As that will do it for the timeout, so the teams are trying to get a little peek at the coach's play that he drew up, but from here it just looked like a lot of scribbles. So I sure hope the players on the Stingers could read it better than I could.
Oh, I think I was actually able to make it out. It said, win the game, Brian. Back to you.
It was directed at me, win the game, Brian.
Win the game, Brian.
Very ambitious of him to think that I could have a play in the outcome, but I'll accept responsibility.
Don't sell yourself short now.
As now Dana Janvier leaves it for Stephanie Charles. Janvier, the long three is good.
And that three is good till next Janvier.
Wow.
As you seem pretty proud of yourself for that comment. So I'll let you have that one. Is Bouliou. It's a Jean-Philippe back into Pont-Denis. And they're going to call that offensive. Bishop's ball in a 9-point game now.
Well, I'm offended if that's what you mean.
That's. Yard check in for the first time.
Yeah, Yard comes in to replace Ponton. Opportunity to grab a glass of water and take a breather.
Well-deserved breather. With a big rebound. Can't be put in by Cote Colette. And they're playing hot potato out there right now as no one can get a handle of it. Finally, Blanger-Paquette tries to go down low for Janvier. But that is turned over. As those are starting to pile up in the wide open, Alex Boudreau can't get it to fall. And it's going to remain Stingers ball with 1:01 to go in the second quarter. If you're a fan of low-scoring basketball games, you have been in for a treat so far.
It's like a chess game out there. It's very strong defenses of the Concordia State Gators, keeping each offensive team at bay.
And Yard puts it up.
Shanice Yard checks in with her 2 points, first 2 points at that, of this ball game. And you know what? First 2 points of the season.
There it is. No better time. Make this an 11-point lead. And a spinorama move by the Bishop Gator. Number 6, Claire Murphy. A little spinorama. How you doing? Off the window and in. Thank you very much for showing up. And now Boudreau with 23 seconds. Find Jean-Philippe. They get it in deep to Yard. She can't get it to fall. looking for points number 3 and 4 on the season. As they want a fresh shot clock, they say. So they turn the shot clock off. 12 seconds to go in this quarter. 25-16. Looking for last shot. They got to shoot. They don't know that the time's expired. And that will do it for our first half of Concordia Stingers basketball. They lead the Bishop Gaiters 25-16. So we're going to go for a break. And we'll be back with the second half action in 15 minutes. Yeah, and five quick points by the Gaiters have them right back in this game.
Walt Disney World in Florida.
As Barrett puts up the shot and gets it to fall.
The pace has picked up quite a bit in this second half. As both teams, I'm sure, were reminded in their dressing rooms that they are playing for the Shriners Classic here. A very prestigious award in this its third year of presentation.
As the Gaiters trying to hold on to their perfect lead as Bouliou takes their man down and right to the floor. Went down hard. Jean-Philippe. And they're going to say that's against the Gaiters.
Chamberlain kind of having a rough go in the last couple of minutes. Hitting the floor a few times here.
She looks like she's a trooper, so she's just fine. As Ouellette Godchild grabbed the rebound. Kicks it out now, and they tried to find Janvier, and instead found out of bounds. Barrett has it. She's circling around the three-point line. Profette right down low. Nice little pass to Barrett. Gotta like that needle threading she just displayed.
Just weaving great vision by the Concordia Stingers on the playmaking side of the game here. Just threading the aforementioned needle, as you just stated.
Yes, I did.
Couldn't think of a better way to put it.
I'm glad we're finally listening to each other up
here.
Yeah,
it's good. It's good. People helping people stuff. It's powerful. As Caleb Barrett drains the first one.
She's going to try to go two for two here. Makes it a nine-point lead as we stand. And extends it to 10, hitting both her free throws. As Belanger-Paquette holds her pivot foot. Gets it to Jermaine, who's had a mighty third quarter so far. That's only 2 minutes and 35 seconds deep. You know, Bouliou. Gets it to Jean-Philippe. They just work it around the outside. Barrett steps up, tries to hit the long two, unable to do so, and that'll be Gator ball. Belanger-Paquette works up the floor, gets it to Jermaine. She finds Trafford. And that pass is just out of the reach of Chamberlain. Gregoire Boudreau picks it up, a nice little pass to Jean-Philippe, but she couldn't get the mitts around the ball. And now a long three attempt by Profette. A great job following her own shot.
Concordia Stingers just owning the offensive rebounds. I wanted to say boards, I wanted to say rebounds. I said them both in one. Efficiency at its finest.
You got that right. As that pass went through the fingertips of Barrett, so the Gaiters get the ball back down by 10, looking to try to make an impact, and a nice little move by Chamberlain. Then she passes it to herself and ends up traveling. So very adventurous.
That was a very cheeky play by the Bishops Gator.
Gabrielle Chamberlain.
Of course, the daughter of famed basketball player Wilt Chamberlain somehow, I don't know how it happened, as both of their last names are spelled differently.
As they work it around, down low now, Profet just can't get it to fall. As I had something else lined up to say, expecting that to go in. As that passed all the way across, a nice little jump shot by Ulet Godcharles. Eight-point lead, and Chamberlain hits the turf one more time. Going to have to break out the ice packs the next time out. And that shot is just off the mark. And it'll be Gators ball.
.5:31 remaining in the third quarter.
She's looking for a teammate, finds Cote Coet. They kick it out back up top. Do that good Charles. God Charles, sorry. 2 seconds to go. They throw up a prayer and it's not answered.
It looks as if Jessica Ang is going to be checking in. She's only played 11 minutes on the season prior to today. So,
as we mentioned, a good opportunity for the coach to get new players in the game, get some CIS experience for them. Every little bit counts. As we're going to see no basket, as we're going to see a substitution now, as you mentioned. Jessica Ang checks in. See if she can shake the nerves off.
Well, she is playing in front of 5 billion viewers online right now.
Let's not tell her. Could only worsen the case. She's got the ball in her hands now. She's looking for an opening. Finds Boudreaux. I just want to see her drain some three balls. As now with the shot clock running out, she's going to have to throw it up. And that will be a shot clock violation. As we see Pont Denis come in for Profet. As we see Stephanie Charles. She leaves it for Jermaine. And the little jumper finds a new home. As Bailey Trafford picks up two, and Jessica Ang's gonna come up the floor, just weaving, breaking ankles, and finally get it to Boudreaux. Now Barrett has it, kicks it out to Ang, puts it up and off the rim. She gets the ball back. Gets it to Barrett. Down low to Paul and Denis. They're going to say foul to the Bishop's Gators. Number 24, Bailey Trafford. So it'll be Stingers ball.
Rookie Jessica Ang fitting in pretty well with this Concordia Stingers team. Looking like a seasoned veteran.
I have to agree with you. She looks good so far. That goes to Paul and Denis. She's stripped of the ball, though, by Stephanie Charles. And then Kayla Barrett swatted away, but only momentarily. Is Jermaine with another three ball.
A little touch from the Jermaine one. The Bishop Gators.
That's her eighth point of the quarter. And watch out. Bishop's is only down by three.
What is it with these Bishops teams? They're so sneaky offensively. Just when you think it's safe to go outside, here they come, creeping up the back again. 31-28 for the Concordia Stingers, and this score continues to get closer here. Concordia Stingers, I'm sure head coach Keith Pruden is trying to wake up his ball team down there, and Let them know that this team is creeping up on them pretty quickly.
He's just looking for answers down there. He's demanding answers. And he got some. So, 3:28 to go. Third quarter, 31-28. Concordia Stingers leading the Bishop Gaiters. It's been a very interesting...
The last game of the season, they might as well do it.
As Ang picks up the ball.
Waking up at about 9:30 at night.
Is Ang looking for some help? Gets a nice little pick. As it went to Dana Janvier, that's Bishop's in purple. As she's baffled and looking for. A shriek.
Thunderous shriek. That was, of course, our sound engineer, Michael Schreider.
As it did not faze Pondini one bit.
As prior to this, these two attempts at the line, Pondini was shooting 38.9% on the season from the line. So
could have fooled me if you didn't know that status. She made those last two with ease. As we're going to see Cote Coet go to the line. And they exchange free throws. The first one is good.
Oh boy, we got ourselves a shootout at the Beehive. 33-29 in favor of our Concordia Stingers. Make that 33-30, and those sneaky Gaiters are sneaking up again.
So now Barrett gets it to Boudreaux. Nice little shot. She gets it to fall. That looks smooth as silk.
Smooth as silk, Brian. Back to you. I had nothing more to add to that. You hit it right on the head. Good work.
So that's going to go off a stinger. We're going to see Bishop ball. 5-point game, 2:28 to go, third quarter.
Yeah.
Stephanie Charles looking for openings. Can't find anything. And that will be a jump ball as they wrestled for that. So it's been going to be Bishop's ball. 3 seconds to go on the shot clock. And once again, jump ball, but nobody jumps. Still yet to find out the reasoning behind that.
Yeah, we got to find the root for that in the CIS. It should definitely not be called a jump ball.
Did you think of a new name for it?
A referee's discretion. Rolls off the tongue much quicker than jump ball.
So it's just up to him, he just decides to get the ball? I like the color purple. You can have it. As Barrett drives to the net, Pondini with a nice rebound.
Not a bad movie, Brian.
As it looks like Pondini's getting up a little gingerly, laboring back, and That gives the Gaiters time to find an open shot, and Cote Coet.
Gaiters have a pretty big group of fans at the Beehive here tonight. Their Gaiters are giving them something to cheer about.
Now Ang thinking three ball. Fakes everybody else out. Gets it down low. A nice rebound by Gabriel Cote Coet. And hold your horses. 35-34.
Hold your horses and or fillies and or award winners in either category. This game is 35-34 with a minute to go in the third quarter. We've said it time and time again all evening. These Gaiters are sneaky.
They're just downright sneaky. I'm impressed by the, you know, as we mentioned, the team that's only got three wins on the season. You know, down by 13 points, and here they are. As Ang, that's the free throw attempt go. She's going to go for a second one now.
That was the first attempt by rookie Jessica Ang on the season.
The second one looked a lot better. And puts it in. As now they kick it out. Looking for options. A wide open three ball. Off the rim as they were going for their first lead of the game. Bone and knee looking a little better after laboring a little bit, hitting the floor hard. Jessica Ang comes away. Gets it to Boudreau out to Ang. Goes baseline. Jean-Philippe, that shot's a little off. Pony can't get the handle on it. 25 seconds to go in this nail biter.
Pondini looked like she was going to hoof that ball through the wall there for a moment. The frustration mounts. She was unable to get a handle on the ball prior to...
I finally got, he's saying defend. As the boisterous crowd noise didn't affect the Bishop's Gaiters at all. The long three-pointers off the rim. And that will do it for our third quarter. And guess what?
We got a tie ball game.
Oh, you're right.
Sorry to ruin that. You had a good cliffhanger. However, it was quite predictable. 36 points apiece. We got a real nail biter here at the Beehive, and I believe you said that too. I just keep reiterating what you're saying.
I'm sorry for taking all the good lines.
Gonna have to break out my thesaurus this evening and think long and hard about our performance. Me mind. Overs. Wowzers.
That's the first stat you go to.
Yeah, turnovers are my favorite
Nancy
stat.
Nancy negative over here.
Oh, it's my favorite stat. Caleb Barrett. The offensive dynamo of our Concordia Stingers here tonight with 11 points. Then, of course, Katie Germain getting it done for the Bishop Gaiters, who has chimed in with 11 of her own. And we're locked at 36s. Both teams averaging 12 points a quarter. We're going to have to see what happens in this.
Something's got to give.
Fourth quarter. Something's going to give. Something's got to give.
Another good movie.
another pretty good movie. Also, if something's got to give, it could be this wooden plank beneath us. Brian and I have been indulging in far too many sweets lately. And by Brian and I mean myself. Ten minutes to go in the final regular season game for Concordia Stingers women's basketball team. A team that is set to open the playoffs against UCAM. A team that they were 1-3 against in the regular season. Of course, they were 3-0 against the Bishop Gaiters, having some trouble with them here tonight.
And a nice little floater by Boulieu. 38-36. Big fourth quarter on the horizon as Jermaine gets it. I like to see his... As Gregoire Boudreau gets it around the horn to Jean-Philippe. Jean-Philippe once more has it. Picks up a... Tries to pick up a pick from Profet. But they're going to call that a foul on her. And just looking at the foul situation, something Bishop's Gaiters have to worry about is Dana Janvier has four fouls. So she's sitting on the bench right now, protecting her from being fouled out. And a nice little layup falls, and pretty, pretty, pretty.
Katie Germain continuing to get it done for the Bishop Gaiters.
Boudreau has it. Out of Gregoire. And that shot goes off the rim, and Profet just bullies her way out of that crowd.
It was a ferocious battle. Good work by Profet.
Boulieu goes baseline and a little side hand, and Gregoire says, hey, thanks very much. I'll take that. Jean-Philippe gets the shot off. A nice rebound by Boudreau. And she gets it to fall, and she's having a great fourth quarter so far.
All the Concordia Stingers doing very good jobs on that particular play. Picking up on the offensive rebounds. Beaulieu will go to the line for one more to make it a three-point play, which are very valuable. Only 8 minutes to go in the game. They're up 40-38.
That shot is good. 41-38. As the relentless crowd continues to egg on their Stingers. That pass goes all the way across, and Janvier reached into February to grab that one.
Ooh, cheesy, Brian, cheesy.
As Boudreau now, and a long three-pointer by Jean-Philippe, can't get the bounces. It sniffed every rim and couldn't get the bounce.
Head coach Alex Perno of the Bishop's Gaiters screaming some words of encouragement to his troops.
It was a thunderous voice.
Almost as thunderous as this voice screaming, defend to the right of me. My esteemed colleague said it sounded like he was saying deafen, which is exactly what he's doing to him. Brian. That was credit to Max Caron, actually. Those were his words, so. I gave him a fist bump. I thought that was very good. Max Caron, perhaps next in line to be a broadcaster of the Concordia Stingers. Got a long way to go, but he's getting there.
We've taken him under our wing and taught him everything he knows.
In all aspects and walks of life. A jump ball again. Of course, I would call it the referee's discretion.
You might want to not teach him that one. Leave that one off the class agenda.
That'll be worth 5 marks on your final exam.
As they draw the offensive foul, a good job to hang tough by Boulieu.
Ooh. Shake it up down there.
In the face of a driving Stephanie Charles. She stood her ground, took the punishment, and got the call. As Kayla Barrett has it now, 6:40 to go, 3-point lead. Boudieu, and a nice little interception by Janvier as the defend cheers rain down again. Not sure who got the foul yet. It's Profet once more.
6:22 remaining in the fourth quarter. Last game of the regular season for our Concordia Stingers. And this arena or gym fell very silent again when I was speaking. No need to worry, it won't be silent for long. It's the cheers of encouragement of our defending team rain down.
We get a travel call. Stingers come. And a three-pointer from Gregoire Boudreau just to the left is. It's going to be Stingers' ball, though.
Beaulieu was almost shown the exit on that play. That door ripped wide open. Surprisingly, the first time I've seen that happen in these gyms. Could be a bit of a hazard.
That little floater. Can't find the bottom of the basket. Stingers capitalize on the rebound. Boudieu sends it all the way back. Barrett doing a little trickery. There's now Boudieu. Nice little fake. Gregoire Boudreau turns and fires. That goes off of Bishop's and out. A little bit of mic trouble up here.
What did I do?
The state-of-the-art microphones that we have up here. As now, down low, Janvier misses. Tries again, misses. She's looking like me at halftime right now. She can't get either of those to go. As Barrett can't get Murphy out of her face with a relentless defender. Little spark plug out there. They're going to say a 3-second in the key violation.
Gregoire Boudreau was a little confused as to where her woman went that she's supposed to be covering.
As Murphy's pass sails by the intended target, Chamberlain, and out of bounds. And Boudreau trying to shake her defender. And these Bishop's Gaiters are playing some airtight defense, and Murphy is fun to watch on defense.
She's got a very in-your-face style and sporadic.
Oh, and it's going to cost her, though, as she's a little too much contact. Still, I like her style.
Me too.
That's all I wanted to know.
Yeah, I figured.
And the first one is good. Yasmin Jean-Philippe. Going for the second one. 4-point lead now. They tried to extend the lead. And that one rattles out. But Kayla Barrett. And they have to call that foul. And they do. So she's going to go right back to line. A great offensive board off the missed free throw. Got to like that hustle. And we're going to get almost a wholesale change here as we're going to have a whole new Bishops team come on.
Wholesale change. Wowzers.
4-5.
Interesting strategy with only 4:23 to go in a ball game, Brian.
Well, the lone one that didn't get changed, Gabrielle Coet, not sure what she did to stay on the court, but she did something right. And I think Profet forgot that they were shooting two. She jumped in there. They were just showing a little enthusiasm. As they sink that and extend it to a 6-point lead. As this new Bishops lineup tries to get some points in a nice little spinorama, but they call it a travel.
Bum, bum, bum.
But the ref said,
No way. Not today.
Travel. So
you were in direct violation of keeping the ball dribbling whilst you were making forward progression. Thus, I blew my whistle and made the call.
So why don't I just give you a free timeout, go back to the bench, think about what you did, talk it over with the coach, and that's all at the referee's discretion.
Full circle, folks. You see how he did that? It's like a finely written sitcom.
That gets canceled immediately.
It doesn't even air a pilot.
So, well, we got a quick break. Let's talk about the playoff schedule. The men will be taking on... Sorry, it slipped my mind. Okay, so the women on Wednesday, March 2nd, will be taking on UCAM at UCAM at 7 o'clock. They have a webcast. Be sure to tune in to support your Stingers. Meanwhile, I'll get back to you on who the men will be playing and Beaulieu sinks the three to extend this lead.
Big three ball by Beaulieu, who's been lights out in this fourth quarter.
As now the Bishop tries to counter, drive through the lane, a little baby hook.
Katie Germain's also been the more dominant Gator the whole game. Oh.
And she put that one in neatly.
Although I don't think Bailey Trefford got it, but anyways.
I had nothing to do with that.
Oh, okay. Just her teammate, okay.
There's now a wide open layup attempt, and no mistake made by Gabrielle Cote-Coet. And just to quickly back to you, the men on Tuesday, March 1st at 7 o'clock, live from the Beehive, will be taking on UCAM. You can join us for that on Tuesday, so we're going to hopefully see you there. And then Profet gets it to fall plus one. So extends the 7-point lead. We did get confirmation that it was by Bailey Trafford. So luckily my reference fit.
That's Bailey Trafford. And yes, you are correct. My apologies, Brian. I should have never doubted you to begin with. Don't know what I was thinking.
That's okay.
Back to you.
As the Stingers are able to extend this lead to 8 points now, they're going to make it really difficult for Bishops to come back. That long three is off the mark, so that's not going to help. As it's hit up to Kayla Barrett. She leaves it for Gregoire Boudreau. They're going to try to kill off a little bit of time here. That's knocked away, so it won't be a backcourt violation. 3 seconds to go on the shot clock. Let's up the prayer, and again, sadly unanswered, but I like the in-your-face defending of Profet myself as well. She doesn't take any guff in the paint.
No, she doesn't, Brian. Nor should she. She shouldn't get pushed around, and she certainly won't let it fly. Certainly won't let it fly. There's an H in there somewhere, folks.
So 2:02 to go. 8-point lead. The Stingers looking to hold on. They played a really inconsistent game, at times showing flashes of brilliance, at other times going in a bit of a drought, letting the team come back after gaining such a big lead.
Yes, the lack of consistency in today's game has been fairly apparent, including streaks of brilliance and streaks of futility. As we remember, it was only 25-16 at the half. It has now emerged into a 50-42 ball game. So,
and remember, the Bishop Gaiters could only muster up 5 points in the first quarter, which led to them needing to catch up.
And of course, I said that it was 25-16 at the half. Well, this game's pretty well right on pace with that, because there's only 6 points of difference if you were to double the score at half. So I don't know why I acted so surprised there. Perhaps I didn't explain that very well enough. Do you understand?
No.
As they work it around the outside. And that's a wide open three attempt, and that's shy of the mark.
So shy.
As they get it up to Boulieu. Back. It's going to send her to the line, Gabrielle Cote-Couet. I'm hoping I'm saying that right.
I'm sure you're not.
So, first attempt of two in a dead silent...
Ooh.
Arena.
I don't envy your position on that particular call, nor do I envy myself at this particular moment. The hush really fell over the building.
I think it's just everyone trying to listen to us. They just, they're envious of the viewers back home who get to listen to
actually,
us.
Actually, Brian, to be perfectly honest with you, I think they just really want to hear who's going to be the Philly of the game.
Wow, there's a lot of options.
My mind is working overtime.
Great song. So this will go to the Stingers. And that will be a bonus, so that'll send him to the line. This is a spot of the game where efficiency at the free throw line can really seal the game if they can make their shots here. Taking advantage of the bonus. Couldn't get the first one. Her second attempt is good. Makes it an 8-point game. 1:10 to go. He's here. Comes in a nice little floater from Cote-Couet. She's been playing well lately. They get it to Barrett. Trying to waste off a little more time. 49 seconds to go. A basket now could seal it. 4 seconds to go on the shot clock. She's going to have to hurry. Profet, a nice little spin move. And the referee calls a travel, but doesn't say it as exaggerated as the last travel call.
Were you speaking?
Not to me,
you.
I hope. Okay, good.
37 seconds to go. 6-point game. Philly of the night. Still up for grabs.
Yeah, I had a lengthy debate with my statistician here, Max Caron, about who should be the horse of a game. We didn't agree. And I'm going to take who I liked as horse of the game. That's what we decided.
Sorry, I wasn't listening.
I figured you weren't. I've made up my mind about the filly of the game.
Oh, my.
Yes.
I wish I had been listening the first time.
Well, now your interest is piqued.
I believe my oh my stated my interest perfectly. Bishop's ball, they got to score on this possession if they want a chance to come back. They go all the way across and right on cue, defend comes in and a three-pointer, and maybe that's not Stephanie Charles' shot. She's having a little bit of trouble. And Gregoire Boudreau is fouled. That'll
fouled.
Send it to the line.
Fouled, Brian. Fouled. Gregoire Boudreau goes to the line.
The first shot. Can't get it to fall. Points the Stingers need to get to seal games. Free throws. Got to take advantage.
22 seconds to go, Brian. 6-point lead.
And almost a big offensive rebound as they're going to have to hurry, though. The long shot is off the mark. Comes back to the Gaiters, and 8 seconds to go, 6 points. It's going to be
very I'm going to make
tough.
The boldest statement that you've ever heard in your life, Brian. The Concordia Stingers women's basketball team has won and captured their first Shriners Classic, is what I would say 8 seconds from now.
Not if I put you on mute. So that shot is good. We're going to see a timeout. Is they're going to have to strategize about the final 8 seconds and how not to give up 5 points. That'll be an interesting diagram.
Be a more interesting diagram to see how you would give up the 5 points in the 8 seconds, I think.
That's on his other clipboard. He didn't bring that one up today.
No need. Guess you don't really want to put it all on the line like that.
It's a risky play.
But strategic nonetheless.
Good or bad, it's a strategy.
This is chess.
So he brings them in.
You got to sacrifice the queen sometimes to get the checkmate on the king, you know?
Please apply that to the situation right now. I'm really interested in hearing that.
You gotta give them the ball and stretch the time out to get the win.
Okay, I'll give that a 4 on 10.
I almost passed.
As they have the foul immediately, 6 seconds to go, and any basket here should seal it.
Well, if the Bishop Gaiters can somehow get the ball and they can get a point per second, they will, in fact, win this ball game, Brian.
Reggie Miller has done it. Although, last I checked, Reggie Miller is not out here, so that's nothing to worry, Concordia fans. And
Cheryl Miller is present.
You know what else has just entered the Beehive? The Shriners Classic Trophy.
There it is, folks. The Concordia Stingers women's basketball team kind of rubbing their hands. Can't wait to hold on to that trophy. First time.
Chomping at that bit to get over there in Selly.
So we're going to stand on our feet to close out the game here.
So that
point. I'm going to be the only one. Okay.
Should do it. As the second one can't fall, but 5 seconds to go. And they're just going to pass it to the corner. And that will do it. The Concordia Stingers have defeated the Bishop's Gaiters 52-46 and will go into the playoffs on a winning note. So, you said you made up your mind. Who's the Philly of the game?
Philly of the game, Brian, is going to go to Magali Beaulieu, who registered 8 points in the fourth quarter.
That is...
And the Concordia Stingers, of course, won by 6 points. So Beaulieu was fundamental in the victory for the Concordia Stingers here tonight.
So, as we mentioned, playoffs coming up. They're on the horizon. From the Concordia Gym, we'll be here bringing you that game, so come and join us for some great basketball. Women start Wednesday, March 2nd. SNCanada.ca. So, on behalf of myself, Gaiters here on Saturday night, and enjoy the rest of your evening.